Hello guys, welcome on Tesla Adventures. In this video, we'll discuss rolling on an inclined plane. So this is a very important topic for all the competitive exams. And let us start by comparing the movement of inertia of some bodies. So first of all, let us write down the movement of inertia of a ring. So the movement of inertia of a ring is mr square. The movement of inertia of a hollow sphere is 2 by 3 mr square, which is almost 0.6 mr square. The movement of inertia of a solid sphere is 2 by 5 mr square, which is also 0.4 mr square. And the movement of inertia of a disc or a cylinder, solid cylinder, is mr square by 2, which is 0.5 mr square. So if we arrange these movement of inertia in increasing or decreasing order, then we will see that the movement of inertia of the ring would be the greatest, which is mr square. Then it would be the movement of inertia of hollow sphere. Then it would be the movement of inertia of disc. And the least movement of inertia among these round objects is of the solid sphere. So this is the order of movement of inertia. This is the decreasing order of movement of inertia. Now, why I am discussing the movement of inertia? Because we are considering that there is some unidentified object, which is a round object. It may be a ring, it may be a hollow sphere, it may be a disc, or it may be a solid sphere. Now, we will analyze the different physical quantities of this body, considering that if it is a ring, then what is the value of that physical quantity? Or it is a hollow sphere. If it is a hollow sphere, then what will be the quantity of that? What will be the value of that physical quantity for hollow sphere, and so on. So first of all, let us see that if this is the movement of inertia, then this will be the sequence of movement of inertia, and the highest movement of inertia will be for the ring, and the lowest movement of inertia will be for the solid sphere. So this is the solid sphere and this is the ring. Now we know that we have to compare different quantities like kinetic energy, the velocity, angular velocity of this object when it will descend down the inclined plane. So let us first of all start by the kinetic energy. So first of all, we know that this object will always roll purely on this inclined plane, because we are only concerned with pure rolling. So V will always be equal to R omega. So V is always equal to R omega, and therefore pure rolling will occur. Now if V is equal to R omega, then the velocity of this point B will be zero, and therefore the friction acting on this sphere will be of a static nature, and the direction of friction would be in the upward direction along the incline. This friction will be of a static nature. This is of static nature because it is rolling friction, and we all know that in the case of pure rolling, the friction is a static nature. So this friction would be acting in the upward direction due to the fact that mg sin theta would be acting in the downward direction like that. This is mg sin theta, and mg sin theta would be applying some force on the center of this object so that its center would be moving with an acceleration of a. Now to rotate this object in clockwise direction so that it may pure roll, so a friction would act in the upward direction, so it would produce a clockwise torque which would rotate this circular object in clockwise sense, so that V is equal to R omega and A is equal to R alpha. So to establish the condition of pure rolling, the friction needs to act in the upward direction, and the nature of this friction is static. So we know that the work done by the static friction is zero. So this work done is zero on this round object, and therefore the work done by mg on this object is mgh, as it will descend down. So mg is acting in the downward direction, and when it will descend down to the inclined plane, then the height by which it descended is h. So the work done by mg is mgh. Okay, now this work done by mg is utilized in changing the kinetic energy of the body, which means the final kinetic energy of the body minus initial kinetic energy of the body is equal to the work done by mg. So mgh is equal to k minus 0, because initial kinetic energy was 0. So we can say that the mass of each object is, if this object is disc, or if this object is hollow sphere, or if it is a ring, or it is a solid sphere, the mass of each of them is equal and the radius of each of them is same. Therefore, work done by mg on each of them is same, and the kinetic energy of hollow sphere, or the kinetic energy of ring, or the kinetic energy of solid sphere, or the kinetic energy of disc would be same, which means that when this object will descend down, the kinetic energy of this object would be same irrespective of the fact that whether it is disc or whether it is ring or solid sphere or hollow sphere. So the kinetic energy of all these four objects will be same. Now to compare the velocity with which it will descend down, so let us first of all write down the value of kinetic energy. So let us suppose that at the lowest point, I'm again drawing the diagram. So at the lowest point, let us suppose that the velocity of the center is v and the angular velocity is omega. So the kinetic energy will be equal to half mv square. This is the translational kinetic energy, as well as the rotational kinetic energy would be half I omega square, where I will be equal to mk square, where k is the radius of gyration and omega square is equal to v square by r square. So if I take out half mv square common, this is small m obviously. So if I take out half mv square common, then it is 1 plus k square by r square. Now this k is radius of gyration and this k is kinetic energy, so don't mix them up. So this is kinetic energy. Now we know that the kinetic energy for each one of them is same. So the object which will have the greater value of k would have the lesser value of v. So this is very important, and we have already compared that the highest moment of inertia is for ring, and therefore the highest radius of gyration would be for ring. So if I write down the sequence of radius of gyration, then k for ring would be greatest. This k is radius of gyration, and then it is for hollow sphere, k for hollow sphere, and then it is for disc, and then for solid sphere. So we have already discussed that for all of them the kinetic energy is already constant. So the object which has the greatest value of radius of gyration would be having the least value of velocity when it will descend down. So we can say the velocity will be in the reverse order. So velocity of the ring would be the least, and velocity of the hollow sphere would be greater than the ring, then the velocity of disc. And then the velocity of the solid sphere. So we can say the velocity of the solid sphere would be greatest among all of them, Now, we all know that V is also equal to R omega. So, if we write down the sequence of omega, considering the fact that mass and the radius of each of them is same, so if we write down the sequence of omega, then the sequence of omega would be same as that of the velocity. So, the omega for ring would be least, and then omega would be higher of hollow sphere, then omega of disk would be higher, and then omega of solid sphere would be higher. So the highest omega would be of solid sphere and the least omega would be of ring. So this is the sequence of velocity, linear velocity and the angular velocity. Now let us find out the sequence of acceleration. We know that this object has mg sine theta, which is acting from the center in the downward direction, and the friction is acting at this point in the upward direction along the incline. But obviously this object is accelerating in the downward direction, so mg sine theta would be greater than the friction. So if we write down the equation of force, then mg sine theta minus friction would be equal to ma. You can see the diagram that mg sine theta minus friction is equal to ma. Now if we write down the equation of torque about the center, this is the center. So you can see that the torque of mg sine theta would be zero, because mg sine theta is passing through this point only and we are calculating the torque about the same point. So the torque of friction would be F into R, and that torque would be equal to I alpha. So the torque about O is F into R is equal to I alpha, where I is again the moment of inertia, so let us write it as I only, into alpha. Alpha is A by R. So F is equal to I A by R square. Now if I substitute this value of F in the above equation, then it is mg sin theta minus I A by R square is equal to ma. And mg sin theta is equal to m plus I by R square into A, which is common. So A is equal to mg sin theta upon m plus I by R square. Okay, so this is the acceleration, and you can see that acceleration is again inversely proportional to the moment of inertia. So the highest moment of inertia would create the lowest acceleration. So the highest moment of inertia is of that ring. We know that the highest moment of inertia is of ring, and therefore the acceleration of the ring will be the lowest. So the acceleration of the ring will be lowest, and then there would be the acceleration of hollow sphere, and then the acceleration of disk, and then it would be for solid sphere. So the highest acceleration would be for the solid sphere and the lowest acceleration would be for the ring. So obviously the object which is having the greater velocity down the incline would be accelerated by a higher acceleration. So we have already discussed that the solid sphere is having the greater velocity down the incline. So obviously its acceleration would also be highest. So this is the sequence of acceleration of these objects. Now if we compare the friction, so if we substitute this value of A in this equation, then friction will be equal to F will be equal to I by R square into A, where A is mg sine theta divided by m plus I by R square. So F will be equal to mg sin theta upon, this is m R square by I plus this is 1. So you can see that if this moment of inertia will increase, then this m R square by I will decrease and friction would increase. So I can say that friction is proportional, directly proportional to the moment of inertia in the sense that if we will increase the moment of inertia, then friction acting on that body will also increase. So the greatest acceleration is for the ring. In fact, greatest moment of inertia is for the ring. Therefore, the greatest friction would be acting on the ring. So F of the ring would be highest, and then friction on hollow sphere, and then friction on disc, and then friction on solid sphere. So this is the sequence of friction. Now, if we compare the time in which they will descend down. So T is the time in which they will descend down. So we know that the object which is having the highest acceleration would take the least time to descend down. So if we compare the acceleration, then the highest acceleration is for solid sphere, so it will take the least time to descend down, and the lowest acceleration is for the ring, so it will take the highest point to descend down. So if we write down the sequence of time, then this is time for the ring, this is time for hollow sphere, this is time for disc, and this is for solid sphere. So we know that the highest acceleration is for solid sphere, so it will take the least time. So I can say that the time taken by the ring would be highest, and the time taken by the solid sphere would be the least to descend down. Now we move on some numericals which are based on the rolling on inclined plane. Now in this first question, you can see that there is a solid sphere which is released from the rest from top of an inclined plane of inclination theta. Now we have to choose the correct options regarding that solid sphere. So first of all, the first option is written as the minimum coefficient of friction between sphere and the inclined plane to prevent slipping is 2/7 tan theta. Now we know that we have already discussed that the value of friction is mg sin theta upon mr square by I plus 1. So if we use this value directly, so F is equal to mg sin theta upon mr square by I plus 1. So this is the value of friction which is acting on a object which is rolling on an inclined plane. Now for solid sphere, the friction would be mg sin theta divided by mr square by I, where I is moment of inertia, so it is 2/5 of mr square plus 1. So cancelling this mr square with mr square, so it is 2/7 mg sin theta. So this is the value of solid sphere. Now if we this is the value of friction for solid sphere. Now the maximum possible friction is equal to mu mg cos theta. Okay, we know that on an inclined plane the normal reaction is equal to mg cos theta. So the maximum possible friction is mu mg cos theta. Now we know that for pure rolling it is necessary that the friction, maximum friction, should be greater than the friction which is applicable on the object, or we can say that the maximum friction should be greater than the static friction or rolling friction. So the maximum friction is mu mg cos theta, and it should be greater than or equal to the static friction acting on the solid sphere, which is 2/7 mg sin theta. So cancelling this mg with mg, mu should be greater than or equal to 2/7 tan theta. So this is the value of mu, minimum value of mu, for which there will be pure rolling of solid sphere on this inclined plane. So option number A is correct, obviously. Now, the kinetic energy of the solid sphere as it moves down by a distance s on the inclined plane is mg sin theta if mu is greater than 2 by 7 tan theta. So listen carefully this one. So if compare the condition mu is greater than 2 by 7 tan theta, then we know that pure rolling is occurring, because for pure rolling to occur, mu should be greater than 2 by 7 tan theta. And if mu is greater than 2 by 7 tan theta, then pure rolling will occur. So if pure rolling is occurring, then the point of contact would not move on that surface, and therefore work done by the friction would be zero. So if work done by the friction would be zero, then the work done by mg would be equal to, I can say that work done by friction is zero. So work done by mg will be equal to the final kinetic energy of the object, because the initial kinetic energy was zero. Now the work done by mg will be equal to mg sin theta into s. So work done by mg is equal to mg sin theta into s, and that is equal to the kinetic energy of the object. So this is the kinetic energy of the object if it is rolling purely, and for pure rolling mu should be greater than or equal to 2 by 7 tan theta. This we have already discussed. So option number B is also the correct one. Now option number C, that the magnitude of work done by the friction on the solid sphere is less than mu mg s cos theta as it moves down by a distance s on the inclined plane if mu is greater than 2 by 7 tan theta. So obviously if mu is greater than 2 by 7 tan theta, then pure rolling is occurring on the inclined plane. And in the case of pure rolling, the work done by the friction is zero. So option number C is also correct. Now option number D says that the magnitude of work done by the friction on the solid sphere is equal to mu mgs cos theta as it moves down by a distance of s on the inclined plane if mu is greater than 2 by 7 tan theta. So this is obviously incorrect. So the correct options are only A, B and C. Now let's move on the next question. In this question, there is a solid sphere which is in the state of pure rolling on an inclined plane, and the inclination angle of the inclined plane is theta. Now we have to choose the correct option. Now it is given that the frictional force acting on the sphere is mu mg cos theta. So this is not correct option, because frictional force in this case, in the case of pure rolling, is not equal to mu mg cos theta, because this is the maximum friction and we know that the frictional force acting is less than the maximum friction or equal to the maximum friction. But in this case, it is not equal to the mu mg cos theta, because this is in the case of pure rolling, and for solid sphere we have already discussed that the friction would act as mg sin theta, in fact 2 by 7 mg sin theta. So this will be the friction force acting on the solid sphere. The friction is dissipative force. This is also incorrect, because dissipative force means that the force which performs some work done to loss energy. So there is no energy loss or heat loss due to the friction, because the work done by the friction is zero in the case of pure rolling on inclined plane. So this option is also incorrect. C is also incorrect. Now the option, in fact, B option is also incorrect. Now option C, that friction will increase its angular velocity and decrease its linear velocity. Now if we draw the direction of friction, then friction would be acting in the reverse direction, and this is the velocity of the sphere and this is the angular velocity in the anti-clockwise sense. So this friction is creating a torque which is also in the anti-clockwise sense. So the friction would be supporting omega and it would be increasing omega, while friction is acting in the opposite direction of the velocity. Therefore, friction would be decreasing the linear velocity. So option C is correct. And if theta decreases, then friction will also decrease. Then obviously this theta will decrease and then friction will also decrease. So option number D is also correct. So the correct answer are C and D.